The speech in this video is generated by Mozilla TTS. See the description for more information. This tutorial shows you how to import a source engine map into Blender. We will be using Mirage from Counter-Strike Global Offensive as an example, but the same steps should work for any other source game or map. Let's begin. First, we will download everything we need. The download links are in the description. We need Blender, of course, which can be downloaded from www.blender.org. Just click the big blue download button on the front page. And another time. Now the file should start downloading. After the download has finished, open the installer. Click Next, accept the license agreement, click Next. Click Next, click Install, click Yes. And now we can download the next thing, which is the Java runtime. Navigate to www.java.com and click the big red download button. No need to read any licenses, just click Agree and start the download. Looks like our Blender installation has finished. Now, we can install the Java runtime. Just install it to the default destination. Now let's download Vspsrc. Navigate to www.github.com/ata/vspsrc. Vsp source requires the Java runtime, which we are installing in the background. Click on the Releases button and download the latest release. We want to open the file since we will be extracting it. Click on Compressed Folder Tools and Extract All. Let's extract it to the desktop for easy access. Create a new folder for it. Select it. And press Extract. We can close the folder for now. Next, we will download Blender Source Tools. Navigate to www.steamreview.org/blender-source-tools. Click on the big green download button and save the file. Next, navigate to www.github.com/losses01/io_import_vmf. Click on the Releases button and download the latest release, and save the file. This is the add-on we will be using to import the maps. Now that everything has finished downloading and Java has finished installing, we can install the add-ons into Blender. First, open Blender. We will use the default settings. You can just close this dialog. Go to Edit and open the Preferences. Go to the Add-ons tab. Click Install in the top right corner. Browse for the downloaded add-ons. First, select Blender Source Tools and click the blue button. Tick the checkbox to enable the add-on. Next, install the Vmf Import add-on the same way. Now, let's configure the Vmf importer. Click the folder icon to specify a cache path. The add-on stores processed game files in there for faster re-imports. Just create an empty folder somewhere with enough free disk space. Select the empty folder and click Accept twice. Next, we need to configure the games we want to import maps from. The add-on uses this configuration to import models and textures from the game files. Click the plus button to add a new game definition. Press the detect button and browse to the installation directory of a game, in this case Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Once you're inside the installation directory, you need to select the game directory. For Counter-Strike Global Offensive, the game directory is called CSGO. Go inside the game directory and press the blue button. As you can see, the add-on automatically detects the game name and required files. Next, let's make sure the preferences are saved. We have now finished installing and configuring the add-ons. Now, we can start importing Mirage into Blender. First, we need to decompile the map using Vspsrc. Open Vspsrc by clicking on the Windows batch file. Click the Add button to add a map to the decompilation queue. Browse to the game installation directory. Go to the game directory, which is CSGO, and then go to the maps directory. Here you can see all the maps in the game. Let's select de_mirage.bsp. Here you can see all the possible decompilation settings. You only need to tick the Extract Embedded Files checkbox from the other tab. After that, press Decompile. We will save the decompiled map into the desktop. Create a new folder for decompiled maps and save the map there. The decompilation should start. It should take around 9.5 seconds. Now the decompilation has finished. We can close Vspsrc and import the decompiled map into Blender. Let's open Blender. We don't need these default objects here, so we can just delete them. Press A to select them all and press Delete to delete them. Next, go to Window and click on Toggle System Console. We can see the progress in the console when we import the map. To import the map, go to File Import and click on Valve Map Format. Let's browse to the decompiled file we saved earlier and select the VMF file. Before importing the map, let's take a look at the import options on the side. Here we have checkboxes to select what we want to import. We can open these panels to reveal more options. First important option is the game definition. Here you need to select the game you are importing the map from. You can leave the embedded files path empty since it will automatically detect the correct folder. Next, we have the brush epsilon. Advanced users may adjust it, but you should use the default value. You can change the invisible brushes setting if you want to import invisible parts of the map, but we will leave it at the default value. The separate option would import them to a separate collection. We will keep the box ticked to import overlays. We also want to import props. Here we have some options we can also adjust, but I recommend you use the default value. We will also import materials. Here is another important option. You should check simple materials if you want to export the map outside Blender. You can leave the other options at their default values here. We also want to import lights and the sky. Here you can increase the sky resolution if you feel the imported sky is too low quality. We will also import the 3D sky origin so we can transform it later. And the scale controls the scale of everything. Click Import VMF to import the map. Bring out the console to see the import progress. This will take at least several minutes and can take up to an hour. Let's speed up the video. Now the map has been imported. We still need to manually select the 3D sky to transform it to the correct position and scale. First, let's make sure we don't accidentally select anything we shouldn't. Disable the extras overlay by unchecking this checkbox. Use middle mouse button to rotate and shift and middle mouse button to move the view. Go into a position where you can clearly see the 3D sky. It is usually clearly outside the map and in smaller scale, like it is in here. Press B and select the 3D sky by dragging a box over it. Go to Object and click on Transform VMF 3D Sky. Now, the 3D sky is in the correct position and scale. We have successfully imported Mirage into Blender. Let's switch into Material Preview to see how it looks. We will also switch Scene Lights and World on to preview the imported lights and sky. As you can see, it doesn't look too bad. If you have any questions, you can ask them in the comments. Thanks for watching.